and you can pass off as Scottish.
Right, so today we're going to start standing just to kind of feel where we are, to feel our energy. So we just want to find that Tadasana posture where we feel really nice connected into the earth. And bring the arms out to the side and just start to feel your arms moving lightly, releasing the shoulders a little bit. Just kind of feel where you are at the beginning of class. And I'm going to add something here to find out how our energy feels in the morning. First, let's stretch the neck side to side and just kind of feel the size of your neck just to find out where you are right now. Just don't force anything, just kind of trying to see how your neck feels in the morning. And then stretch to the other side and see how you may feel on the other side. Just for information, just so we know. And then let's feel our energy. First thing, we're gonna rub our hands together. See how much heat we can produce here. That will increase the energy flowing through the meridians before the practice. And then we'll check again at the end to see how it improved. Now, the other way to really enhance the flow through the meridians of the arms that goes to the lungs and to the heart is to rub our fingernails together. So now rub your fingernails really, really fast. Create some heat here, some tension, some friction, just as far and as strong as you can. So this opens up the meridians in the fingertips, and then it flows through the arms. And now let your arms flow down slowly. Just feel that tingly sensation that travels through your meridians. Maybe you feel it a little bit, maybe not so much, that's okay. Just kind of knowing where we are, and then we'll test this at the end. Okay. So we're gonna work on the neck and shoulders today. So we're gonna be on the wall. We're gonna get these guys next to us. Maybe we may even need a blanket. Everybody has a blanket? Okay, Scott, well, let's get one too. I know I don't need one, but it can be useful. So we're gonna scooch next to the wall and then swing the legs up. That's gonna be the way up. Okay. Now we'll just open the meridians of the legs by working a little bit of the ankle and toes. So bring the legs up. Right leg up towards you and point and flex a few times. Just starting to move through that Achilles tendon, the back of the leg, feeling your hamstring, your sciatic nerve. Just waking things up a little bit. And then circle the ankle inward. Then switch direction. Okay, now keeping the foot flexed, we're gonna reach a little bit up through the back of the leg, just pressing the heel to the sky. We're gonna do some pelvic floor lifts. Inhale, lift the leg up a bit and down. Up and down, six times. Release that leg back down to the wall. And we'll do the other side. Bring the left foot towards you. Point and flex. Feel into the back of the leg, the Achilles tendon, the calf muscle, hamstring. Just activating everything. And circle outwards. And then inward. press into the heel, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Great, bring it back down. Now squish into the wall as far as you're able, considering the hamstrings and so forth. And we will start placing the smaller balls, if you have the smaller size, underneath your shoulders here, just between the shoulder blades on the outside of the spine. So they will be close to the neck, but not too close. Just want to have like a bit, like a half of your palm between the top of the neck and shoulders. And at the very deepest point in the trapezius where it feels really tense, you'll know. And you may need a little slack between the tennis balls, yeah, or out of the mat should be okay too. Uh-huh. All right, so first we're extending the arms out in a T, just like Susan's doing. Okay. And we will keep the palms up to begin with. Just stay here 3 breaths, just observing, see where the intention is, where the intensity is. And probably your palms are floating off the floor at this point. Eventually they might drop and touch the floor in a bit, but they may not. Okay, one more breath in this position. And then we're gonna exhale, rotating the palms down, and inhale, rotating them back up. So it's gonna be a roll from the wrist, but also it's gonna travel all the way to the shoulder. Just do a few of these. Now rotate that palm down towards the floor. This time get your hand just on your fingertips. Touch with all 5 fingers on the floor. So the arms are a little bit elevated and lengthened. And just breathe here. This is gonna wake up the lung meridian quite a bit and of course the inner meridian of the heart. And all these muscles and tendons and nerves that flow down the arm. It's like we're flossing those nerves. 3 breaths here, breathe right into your chest. Good. And now we will move into a sliding movement on the floor, like creating some snow angels. So slide the hands down towards the bottom of the hips, and then inhale, slide them back up as far as you're able, comfortably. Palms are down for this one. Sliding your fingers down, and then inhale them up. Nice. And readjust the circuit calls if you need to. I want to add something to this, guys. You may start to enjoy life. Relax the body a little bit. We're going to put this heavy weight vertical on our belly. So start, just put it right over your, from the pelvis, vertical towards you, vertical. Mm-hmm. Yeah, bring it up towards you like this way. Bring it down. Lay it down on your belly. Uh-huh. Yeah. So even out the weight, so it's all even. Just don't tell your nervous system to relax, even though this is really intense, like on the top and everything. So even out the weight of that thing, yeah. It's gonna tell your heart and belly and just gonna send some impulse of parasympathetic in the body so you can feel like you're relaxing here. Mm-hmm. Okay. So continue that snow angel move. And this is the idea of those heavy weighted blankets if you've ever had one. I enjoy mine. I have one and I sleep with it. It's a little bit more challenging in the summer because no matter how light they try to make them, they get pretty hot. make the cool ones too. So I may have to get me one that pulls you off. All right, so extend the arms back in a T position. And hover here again, just three breaths to reset and reassess, see where we are. Deep in the breath, inhaling for four counts. Hold the breath for four. And exhale for six. The longer the exhalation, the more release happens. We release more tension, more lactic acid, more deoxygenated blood and flow. So it's a nice release. One more cycle. Now let's go ahead and inhale now. Bring the arms up overhead towards the floor, not to the ceiling. And we're imagining we're grabbing a rope and climbing up this imaginary rope. So go with your left hand and right hand climbing up this rope. Or like you're pulling somebody out of the water, you're saving them. So pull, pull. So this is gonna sink those balls into those shoulders and move them around a bit more. So you're gonna get more release. It's gonna go a little deeper and it's gonna move around for you. Nice, left and right. We're just self-massaging this area. Better than your masseuse can do because probably she or he are not that strong. So let's do some self-massage here. Good. Three more, climb to the top. Reach, reach, reach. Exhale, release the arms in a goalpost. So arms to the side, elbow and shoulder aligned. 90 degree angle at the elbow. And stay here. So we're gonna add a little bit of movement here. We're gonna circle the wrist around inward 8 to 10 times. And then outward. Right. And release them back down. If you release a bit more, maybe your hands are coming closer to the floor. Again, come back to those deeper, longer breaths with the holds in between. Just really dissipate that energy around. As we hold, we force the energy to different areas that are tight or resistant or contracted. And as we breathe out, we release all that gathered tension, that stuck energy in the body in shape of knots and cords and things like that. Deepen the breath. You can feel your belly rising and falling against your weighted let you know how you breathe. It does give you a little bit of ab work because you have to use a little bit more pressure to breathe against this pillow. And it calms the heart and the nervous system. All right, now we're gonna add a little bit more movement. Extend the arms to the side in a T. Maybe palms down if you can. If it's too much, keep them up. Because we will move the head now from side to side. Inhale left, exhale right. Just very slow. With the breath, just really getting a little bit deeper, a little bit more intentional into this area. And your tennis balls may slide a little bit, but they're gonna be in the same general area. And even if they move, that's okay. There's no danger to injure anything. But it may get more intense or less intense, depending on how tight you are in those areas. Now let that movement go and make sure you slide back next to the wall in case you got away from the wall by any reason. And we will bring our other set of T-balls. Get them out of the mesh. We'll need them separate for this one. And we'll put them in the middle of our glutes, between maximus and medius, right there. And a little bit on the outside. So when we slide the feet down into Baddha Konasana on the wall, you will feel that area getting massaged right on the outside. So slide your feet down with feet together and knees out to the side. Double action now in the lower body and upper body, and they kind of communicate and correspond with each other. So we're gonna stay here at this one. We can just really feel as we hold the pose. The closer the feet come towards your perineum, the more intensity you get on the outside. So it doesn't matter though, as long as you feel that stretch and that push into this area. Now we're gonna also try and create a diamond shape with the arms. So we will bring the fingertips, index and thumb to touch above the head and just see where the arms would find themselves. They'll be floating up for sure. And we get a little bit different position here and a little bit deeper maybe. So just assess here if it's too much. You can make some adjustments. And maybe if you have that blanket, put the blanket above the head to lift that area up a bit so your hands can rest on that blanket, not so much on the floor. So maybe forcing it a bit. So roll it as much as you need to kind of have your hands rest on that. Yes, put it a little bit under your head and a little bit under your hands. When your hands drop to the floor, they'll be more elevated because this one can be quite intense. All right. Breathe into those points of intensity and know that the energy of the breath is going to shift that energy, transmute it, and transform it. Get back off imagine you have this tractor wheel, and we're gonna veer to the left, and then exhale to the right. Veering left, veering right, just really getting to knit that area a bit more. Pause that arm movement. Now we'll focus more on the lower body, letting those upper T-bones stay in a good comfortable position. Maybe drop them a little lower and a little bit out towards the shoulder blades more. And just let them be there. And we'll focus on the legs now by bending the knees and dropping them to the left. Arms can stay out in a T to kind of stabilize ourselves. We're gonna drop a little bit to the left, not too much. And readjust that lower ball if you need to. Going to feel it on the outside towards that TFL. Or you can just put that left knee down and right leg can stay up if you don't want to put too much weight. Can also turn the head to the right, looking over the right hand. This will add a stretch on the top as well. Across the upper back, from the left side of the neck to the right side of the shoulder. Keeping more stabilized at this point, put that heavy pillow across your waist. Instead of up and down, bring it horizontal. Great. Now we will add the other T-ball on the left side in the middle point of the IT band and extend the leg out to the side. So if it's not touching, if you're not low enough to touch the ball, you may bring your block underneath that ball and then drop the leg out. So you have the block on the floor next to the wall, you have the T-ball on top, and then your IT band drops on it. Mm-hmm. Good. So the right leg stays up, the left leg out to the side open. Man, you got that, Scott? It feels intense. But we're getting through some deep embedded tension. So let's go ahead and focus on that breath again. 4, 4, 6, 2, and start again. 4, 4, 6, 2. So one pause is a 4, another pause for 2. Exhalation 6. Now, if you need more action in the leg, you can point and extend through the toes, flexion. contraction, extension, and see how that moves the energy a bit more. Now we can do some cross fiber action by sliding the leg away from the wall and then heel back into the wall. Inhale, slide away a bit, and exhale, bring it back to the wall. Inhale, exhale, do as many as you like here, 8 or 10 movements. Stop in that neutral position. 3 more meaningful breaths here. Great. Bring the right side tennis ball from the upper body and we bring it under the left arm in the tricep area with your palm up and let the weight of the arm rest on that. Your head turns to the right to feel that action. And we're gonna make a fist here with the left hand and then open. Make a fist, squeeze your thumb on the inside and open. Enough weight still in the leg area. And now with the palms stretched open wide, just roll side to side, cross fiber in this area below your triceps or in the middle of the tricep. Whatever it feels good. In the belly of the muscle usually is the best area to start. And if that doesn't feel enough, you can drop it to the origin or lower to the insertion point. And a good, very tense point would be in a little bit, we'll drop it next to the elbow. So we're gonna travel the elbow down a bit more, just close to the elbow with the palm up still. Head to the right and take a few breaths here. And feel how this connects that ball between the shoulder blades. So a little bit away from the midline maybe, and it's closer to the shoulder on that left side. And then close to the elbow. And feel this energy flowing from the elbow to the shoulder. Activating this transmission of energy. You may feel quite intense at the top of the neck there. 2 more breaths. How's everybody doing? Gary, good? Okay. Scott, we're surviving there?
Yeah.
Suzanne, you're good?
I'm good.
Awesome. All right, let's release that side and we'll do the same on the right side. So bring the left knee back up. We're gonna move both tennis ball back in the upper spine, the upper body. And we'll have the tennis ball back under the right TFL area with the right knee bent. Dropping some weight down to the right, left leg can stay up or can lean towards the right side as well. See how you feel. Maybe first keep it up a bit to not have that much pressure right away. So
So we're going to explore just in the upper point. And maybe if we move that left tennis ball closer to the root chakra at the base of the spine, we can still get some imprint right there. Just really close to your tailbone at the bottom of the roots of the tail. We can get some imprint there. Your weight is still across your waist. Good. And let's turn the head to the left, activating this arm and shoulder and stretching the scalenes on the right, activating the vagus nerve on the right side of the neck. Connect with your breath and take those long, meaningful, connected, exploratory breaths, sending the energy to where it's needed mostly. The mind intention, the breath's energy is gonna change this up, release this area. And when you have the head turned, you may feel more intensity at the base of the neck on the left side. To get out of that, do a few movements of the head, center and side, center and side, just to move that tension. Okay, let's move that left side tennis ball on the middle of the IT bend and extend that right leg out so we can drop into the IT bend. Move that pillow a little bit over the hips so you feel that heaviness supporting you and centering you. And we'll keep the head turned to the left and right leg stretches out to the right. Do some point and flex here, moving through this area. Create a circular movement in the ankle. Reverse the direction. And then start to move that heel towards the wall and away from the wall, getting to that cross fiber action in the TFL and the IT band. Get any tingling nerve sensation down the leg, you're doing too much, so make sure you don't feel any nerve sensation. If you do, just readjust. Okay, now we will keep that leg there and move the left tennis ball on the right side of the tricep. Extend the arm back out and turn your head to the left. And let's open and close the fist here. Close your thumb on the inside and open it, stretch it, and squeeze and release. Now do some lateral sliding movement with the arm. closer to the elbow. Such a habit for me to call it tennis ball because I brought this practice maybe 20 years ago in my yoga classes, and back then we only had tennis balls. We didn't know about therapeutic balls. So we said, everybody bring your tennis balls from the garage. That will be fine. So see what you feel there next to the elbow. Those are very tense muscles, tendons that insert in the elbow and nerves that travel down the arm. So it can be a lot of tension here too. All these minute muscles of the digitorum, of all the digits are activating around the elbow. So it can be a lot that we release here too. So explore, maybe circle your wrist and see how that feels. Both directions. Move and roll the wrist up and down. Just to move and transform this energy. Two more breaths here in a stable position, just stabilize everything. You can move the lower T-ball next to the knee a bit more if you'd like. For the next couple of breaths, lean more weight into the right. Head is still to the left. Two more breaths. See how much deeper you want to get. And notice the release. Know that you would feel like a newborn baby at the end. So we'll just keep that image in mind. Don't worry about what's going on right now. See the bright future. All right, then let's slowly release that. Bring the leg back up. Realign right in the center, keeping that weight horizontal still. We're gonna bring the upper T-bones right in the crook of the neck, so that we're really close to the neck and upper part of the shoulders. So they're almost falling out, but not quite, okay? So now we're gonna bring the hands in front of the chest. You're gonna do some rolls. Imagine you're doing these rolls like we would do if we were sitting. You may not go back too far, but you're going forward. So, just moving the energy here a bit. Bring the elbows as high up as you can and then slide them down and in. Just a few rotations here. Just notice how it sends impulse all the way to the elbow. You're going to feel those nerves and those muscles communicating and collaborating. Now with the head turned to the right, head towards the right shoulder, slide this elbow up on the left side and then down towards the ribcage. Just sliding it up on the floor and then down. Nice. You can do rotation if you want for a few times, but then just do a slide, touching the floor or not, sliding up and then down. And your head is turned to the right. Okay. Got it. Nice. Yeah. And turn back to center. And do that rotation on the other side. Sliding elbow down towards the ribcage and up towards the head. And imagine it touches the floor, even though it doesn't. Mm-hmm. Nice. Just a few more here.
finish this wall posture. It's quite long. Getting rid of one of the ball and bring just one right behind the heavy part of your head, the skull, not the soft part, right in your area where your head would hit the pillow first. Just to send a relaxation message down the spine to soothe the nervous system at the end of the practice here. So it's gonna be right above your cerebellum. Take some deep breaths. Letting this energy of release and relaxation flow down the sides of your neck and shoulders, down the arms and chest. More breaths there, and then we already come off the wall. We're gonna be more lengthwise on the mat with the knees bent to get a little bit on the inside of the arm to release this levator muscles of the arm. So we can have the knees bent and roll onto our left side and put one tennis ball under the tricep and one under the right under the shoulder, under the armpit. We're gonna rest our weight into that arm, our head resting on the arm. So you're gonna slide forward and back a little bit. Your right hand can be on the floor and do some sliding movement here to come across that thick muscle fiber under the arm that helps us work and lift things and lift weights and other things, get our stuff from the higher cupboards in the kitchen, everything like that. So it's a very tense area. So breathe as you gently move here. Maybe stop in a neutral position where you can hold for two breaths. Those deep, long breaths. Release that side and we'll do the right side as well. Then we will check the body, see how we've done, and then do our meditation. So slide here on the left side. See what you find here. Could be a little different, a little more or a little less, hopefully. And just drop your head onto that arm and decide how much weight you want to put by using your left arm to either lift a bit or release. And do any movement that feels good, circular or cross fiber here. Just find your way into a somewhat pleasant but quite unpleasant as well. Sorry. But you guys know what we're talking. You know the language of myofascial. Whew, yeah, this gets me more than the other side. Well, I need this one a lot more than you guys do, probably. It's really getting me here. Connect with those deep breaths and find a point where you want to just hold still. Or maybe lean your chin down to get a little bit more
inward action.
You can scream, you can moan, but we're done. I think we did it. Okay, let's come out. Gonna move up and just kind of check ourselves where we are now. Let's stand and start to move your head side to side. See how you feel through the neck. Maybe do some rotation. Continue to move that energy. And maybe move the other way, just explore into this neck. You may feel a lot better than before, right? And now let's do that. Check of the meridians, just bring up that heat into the palms. So there's energy centers through the body, and one of them is in the middle of our palm. So when we bring all of this heat, it's gonna collect itself in the center of the palm, and we can feel it. And now we're gonna do the nails. Bring that heat, bring that energy, activating the tips of the meridians. And as we release the hands slowly, feel that tingling sensation. Feel that energy flow through your fingertips, up the wrist, up the arms, all the way to the neck. Enjoy this energy. It's your own energy, your chi, your vibration. And we can always increase this, increasing it by doing this technique from Qigong practice. Stop until you feel that sensation going and really enjoy it traveling through your body. It can be a pulsating feeling, heat, vibration, tingling, any of those. Great. Okay, now we will sit comfortably for the next minutes to do a beautiful meditation. So you can even sit on your heavy pillow here. That's always a good prop. Or your blanket, or whatever feels good. Cross the legs. We're gonna do that levitation meditation, so you guys can get an idea what we did yesterday. It was fun. And sitting up tall in those sit bones, just find your posture now that the shoulders are released. You can drop them down and back and really open the chest. And feel your posture here with uplifted spine, all the cervical vertebrae connecting to the thoracic and lumbar, and just having this nice open chest with released shoulders. And maybe hands can be on your knees or in your lap. If you didn't use your pillow to sit on, you can put it here and rest your hands if that feels comfortable, or at your knees, it's also great. You just want to feel like really, really comfortable. Close the eyes. Long breaths, four counts to the inhale, pause for four, exhale for six, pause for two. So we'll practice this breath throughout the meditation. And now, your eyes closed.
eyes up and in, focusing between the eyebrows at your Ajna chakra, and project out of the screen of your mind right in front of you, about 10 inches in front, an image of you having the biggest smile. Bring to mind the happiest moment of your life, when you felt really joyful, really uplifted, really happy, with a big smile on your face, from your lips, from your eyes, from your mind. Just the biggest, happiest smile. Keep this image of this big open smile and bring it into the Ajna chakra, right between the eyebrows, increasing the energy of this chakra. Our creativity, our creation here, our mindfulness, our intuition. So as we add the energy of happiness and joy to anything, everything gets uplifted. So we'll bring this energy of happiness and joy into the throat chakra. So imagine this big smile across your throat, right below your jaw, and really widening and going all the way to the collarbones, and smiling big from shoulder to shoulder. We'll drop this smile at the heart center, the heart chakra, smiling big across your rib cage, from right lung to left lung, from right arm to left arm. Big smile in your heart. And feel your heart uplifting, all these myocardial cells dancing around, having a party, happy and joyful. Moving around from the two atrium to the two ventricles, communicating, enjoying each other. And we'll drop the smile to the Manipura chakra around the navel point. Imagine this big sunny filled smile across your waist, right around the navel, like a shield of energy around you that is very uplifting, happy, and joyful. And start to feel your body lightening up, feeling light and lit up at the same time. And we'll drop this energy of smile and happiness into the area below the navel, the Svadhisthana chakra, for creation, creativity, and relationships. Smile big across your waist. Uplifting this area, rejuvenating, integrating. Now, big smile at the base of the spine for the root chakra, for our grounding and connection with Mother Earth, our stability in life. Feeling grounded and supported, happy and elevated. Now, the body is so light and happy, genuinely joyful, surrounded by light and by space. Focus your mind at the top of the head, at the Sahasrara chakra, that small area in the top of the head that used to be the fontanelle when we were young. That was a soft spot, but now it's closed. We are opening it, however, with the energy of this light, that travels from above into our head. Imagine a funnel that brings this vibrant lavender light energy into the head, opening up this chakra. And then continue to drip down into the whole chakra system, through the center, and then through the sides of your head, your ears, your shoulders, your arms, your hips, as wide as the knees. And imagine this lavender light filling up your body. Space above your head, infinite space above your head. Bring this infinite space between your ears. Imagine space between your left and right ear. Plenty of space, infinite space. Your head is space, in space. Imagine space in front of you, infinite space in front of your body, infinite space behind you, plenty of space to the left and to the right. Imagine space. See space. Feel space. Space underneath you. Space above you. Space to the right and to the left. Space front, space in the back, and you are space, floating in space. Space in your heart, space in your mind, infinite space in the body. Your body is space, in space. Your mind is space, in space. You are part of space, and you are space. Space is in you, space is outside of you. Surrounded by space, a ball of space in space. And you're traveling through the galaxy, jumping from star to star, galaxy to galaxy, traveling through the Milky Way. Infinite space. No body, no mind. Just breath and spirit in space. Feeling serene, joyful, happy and delighted to have this experience of space. Space between the cells. At the cellular level, we are 99.9 space. Just like the universe, there's more space than matter. Experience space. Be space. Enjoy being spacious. And float in space. Take a journey in space. infinite existence, omnipresent, omniscient, never dying. Open the eyes, start to move your neck and shoulders a little bit. End this class with sharing our love for yoga. Thank you for coming from my heart to yours. Namaste. Okay, good. All right, take a little time to really come back. Don't drive right away.